There we go. Welcome to Where Art. This one's called Breakfast. It's just a little watercolor using Daniel Rene's watercolor. Sometimes I don't mention the watercolor paper that I use. Something that you can get at Walmart. And I have my brushes full of watercolor diluted into the brushes, so this way I can brush straight on, but of course they start clogging up, so I have to find better watercolor that won't clog up. Chips. Got another good chips. I'm just coming up with new ideas or just projects for watercoloring and something to do with this watercolor so I can use it all up instead of letting it sit here and dry out and be absolutely useless. There's not that many artists that I know around that could use this stuff, so I can't give it away. And I don't think any of the Goodwill services even take them. Now, while watercoloring, a lot of people like to have it even and smooth and perfect. Sometimes I like the whole watercolor organic feel, that it's splotchy and there's a texture. And in this video, you can't quite see the lightest colors being laid down. Still working on that. Not too sure if it is the camera or not. It is an HD camera, believe it or not. The watercoloring went off without a hitch, really. But I was having problems with dialing back certain colors. Like the background. I really wanted to fade it in a certain way and darken it in a certain way. Which is kind of hard to do with watercolor. It'd be easier doing that with acrylics. Because it's more opaque. Watercolor is more translucent. So, I don't know. I don't think it was bad. There's a lot of artists that are using watercolor to make their comic books. You can find them on Topastic and Webtoons. That's what kind of inspired me to think about watercoloring a couple of comic books I'm coming up with in the future. But I may have to invest in better watercolor, which I don't want to do, because I still have watercolor sitting here. So I have to find ways to use it up. I have no idea if there's a way of selling it. Because me and the site's for sale, you have to pretty much spend a lot of money just to get the place operational. Now, I was using two different colors, the browns, light browns, kind of a sage and a greening. And I decided to go with a pinkish or purplish color. For shadow, I was using a kind of dark gray, and I was using a colored pencil to add little spots or highlights or points. Then I used a little black ink to kind of add a little extra oomph. You'll see that further down the video. As for watercoloring, it's not a bad medium. It's hard to scan in, which is the sad thing. There's a lot of beautiful watercolor, but when you scan it, the scanner seems to blow out certain areas and emphasize other areas. So it makes it look worse than what it is. Sometimes I wonder if I should use a just regular camera and just snap a picture of it. I think I can jerry-rig something that would be like a scanner, but it would be just a one photograph thing. Well, that would be interesting. Hope that your art now did. Getting your webcomics from Webtoons or Topastic. Checking a couple podcasts by a couple artists. Hopefully you're inspired to do more watercolor, or at least outdo what I did. If you want, you can always buy a couple books from Indie Planet that I made. Link is right there. And not much else to say, but enjoy the video and keep on arting.
We have stuff on sale. More things to come. Check out our store.